Hi.
Hi.
Hi. Forgot what I was going to call. a friend of mine just went back into treatment for an eating disorder, which is troubling for me. I was in rehab for an eating disorder about 10 years ago. And she came at me and asked me, what do I do with an addiction to laxatives? I just said, just stop. But someone came at her and said, no one in the United States should have an eating disorder when people are starving in Africa. But I get it. I'm giving her voice. It could have been a dude, I don't know. It's just Facebook. But I get it. It's an addiction. It's like cancer. It's a disease. It's like no one got skin cancer. It's like, this is the shit. You know? How can I get some more of this? There's some paint chips. I'm gonna eat some of those. Who's got some cigarettes? Yeah. It's just like fucking cancer, you fucking cunt. No, it's not. It's a behavioral addiction, and it's not in any way similar to cancer. Now, I have a tumor in my left leg, and that's always a good time, but I'll leave that for another time. Anyone have a good time on St. Patrick's Day? Wow.
Yeah!
I'm here to suck the air out of the room, all right? I wrote this down, but some motherfucker on St. Patrick's Day did a bunch of St. Patrick's Day shit, so I'm gonna do it now. St. Patrick's Day! A celebration of the arrival of Christianity to Ireland, and not douchebags dressing up in green shit and beads just to date rape underage teens. Well, how'd they get into the bars? Well, these bars stopped IDing girls on St. Patrick's Day because St. Patrick's Day has become as annoying as the zombie pub crawl and pedal pubs and basically bridesmaids in general. On St. Patrick's Day, yes, let's celebrate people fighting and being Irish and drinking. Let's get on blackface all through Black History Month. Let's just do that. I got invited to a party for St. Patrick's Day on Facebook, which is adorable. They told me the time, address, etc. of the party, and at the end, in parentheses, they said, bring anyone you want, no douchebags, please. And I just think that's adorable. The idea of the mythological creature that is the self-aware douchebag. It's like, oh wow, a party. No douchebags. Fuck. I knew I shouldn't have taken that selfie with my tank top on, pulled up. You know, I was trying to show off my six-pack abs, but I've been working on them so long I didn't realize I was wearing this visor. I couldn't see it because I was wearing my sunglasses indoors. No douchebag. my girlfriend and I broke up. And I feel like I got a month with a pass. You know? Anything goes bad, it's her fault. I mean, burn the toast. Fuck her! You know? Oh, I was trying to take the trash out of the bag, bro. Whose fault is it, Brittany? That fucking... She's like the new guy at work. Who didn't feel the gorgonzola cheese? Fucking Brad. Who didn't clean the toilet? Brad! I mean, Brad! Fucking Brad. I mean, it's the four-letter curse. Like, Jeff, do you know anyone you like named Greg? Right? I mean, my name is John, but I go by Johnny because I don't want to get lumped in with Todd. Because fuck Todd. Sorry if your name is Todd. I got called into jury duty this year. And I don't think the judiciary system really wants me in the jury box. Because I'm just looking for the story. I'm looking for the joke. Like, if you did something funny, not guilty. Like, hypothetically speaking, you got drunk and took a shit on the Capitol steps. I don't want to put that guy in jail. I want to hang out with that guy. You got drunk and beat the shit out of your wife? That's not funny. Fucking guilty. But then there's the gray area. There's that gray area. There's the guy who got drunk and took a shit on his ex-wife's front steps, and she had a, God, why do I always forget the fucking name of it? When you can't go to your wife's house.
Restraining order.
Restraining order upon her because he used to beat the shit out of her. Well, fuck. Because poop is always funny. I mean, who am I to judge? I pooped in exotic places. I'm a blackout drinker. One day I went to my refrigerator beer for breakfast, realized night previous I had shit my vegetable crisper. And being a blackout drinker, I didn't have the wherewithal to clean that. I just didn't buy perishables for about 2 weeks. My girlfriend once told me that she once shit the bed because she ate too much boldo. Am I dating a toddler? What am I doing with my life? I don't know if I'm worried more about the fact that she shit the bed because she ate too much bubblegum or that she's still used to the term bubblegum. That's like me saying, babe, sorry, I pissed the bed, I drank too much soda pop. My girlfriend, we're having a hard time because she's a terrible conversationalist. She has a hard time communicating. One day she came home and said to me, I just had the weirdest shit at work. And I just walked away. I have questions! What is the weirdest shit? Like, were you pooping blood, coins, and squirrels? Like, was your boss punching a hobo while watching you shit? What is the weirdest shit? We were separated for about 3 weeks, and she sent me a card every day of my birthday, which was very sweet, but I only got six. The seventh one I got 3 weeks later, and she'd written it after we got into a argument on the phone. I guess she remembered it. I did not. And she wrote it out in pen, but wrote it over it in black marker. And in pen she wrote, I just hung up on you. And something about me being an asshole and then saying a bunch of fucks and other things. But in black marker she wrote, mean, angry, bitchy words that I never meant and wish I could take back. Don't give me the fucking card. I mean, that's like taking a shit on some dude's bed and cleaning the sheets and being like, hey, Brian, by the way, a week ago, shit in your bed. While she was gone, she texted me and said, every day I've been gone, I've been masturbating constantly. And I wrote back, I don't want to fucking read this. Go fuck yourself. And I realized, I'm not angry, I'm just redundant. But I love her. We had our good times, you know? We had our good times, us laying in bed, my head in her bosom, you know? And I told her, this feels like home. And I realized either my home growing up, I just either have mommy issues or my home growing up just has small tits. All right, thank you. My name is Johnny Athman.